Is it recording right now?
Yeah. Okay. He just flew under the wires.
It was close.
No, he was under. It wasn't close. He flew under them.
It was over the
wires. No, he flew under the wires. Under the, who says under the wires? He just went. You'll see, it's not, he's videotaping, so you'll know. Justin, I love that your family's hanging out with you today.
Yeah, we're joined today with my wife, Rachel, and our three children, Ella, Ian, and Phoebe.
And I'm so jealous they get to hang out in this beautiful garden. We've got all this great food out here.
Yeah, so this is the best time of the year for the garden. We're really eating a lot out of it.
Yeah, I can imagine. And now there's corn here too. This is shorter than the field corn.
Right, so that's the best way that you can tell the difference between sweet corn and field corn.
Is that the only way? I have to have them stand right next to each other to figure it out. So we're heading out to the fields?
Yep.
Let's get to it.
All right.
I bet you didn't know farmers like Justin are into the latest technology and gadgets, just like the rest of us. Justin uses a drone, well, for fun, but also to fly over his fields to see how the corn is growing and if bugs or weather are having an impact. Justin, it is great to be back out on the farm, and obviously the corn has come a long way. What's going on today?
So what the stage of the corn is in right now is in reproductive state. So you have your tassel that came out the top here, and it's pollinating this potential ear of corn right here.
Ooh. Oh, this is kind of exciting. I've never seen baby corn. Oh, that's beautiful. Now, is this the kind they use like in Chinese food?
No, it's not.
You hit that little baby corn. I wonder where it came from. I thought that was it.
I suppose it could be, but
that's not it. So when I was here last, it was baby corn, and now what is it, like a teenager state?
Yeah, so right now it's entering that reproductive state, and the ear size is being set.
And what's next?
What's next is it'll enter into a doe stage and then a dry down stage.
Okay, and what are you looking for today?
What we're looking for today are lesions on a plant like this,
okay,
and then bugs. So this would be an indication for us to apply a fungicide.
A fungicide?
Yep.
And how do you apply that process?
That would be by a plane.
Okay, but, oh, by a plane. So not like in those sprayers that you had before?
No.
For the herbicide. If you're like me, you're probably wondering how an airplane can apply chemicals safely and precisely. Let's ask Justin how this works. This is technology farmers have used for 100 years. How is it modern technology today?
Well, the modern technology comes into how he's applying with the plane. So
he's coming in really low. Okay, that's spectacular.
So applying fungicides precisely and where they're needed on our crops.
And fungicide sounds a little scary. Is it safe?
It's safe. We have foliar diseases that we're treating for, and yeah.
All right, and now he's spraying a lot of fungicide. I mean, I don't know if it's a lot, but how do you keep it from drifting away from your crops?
There's products that we put in with the mixture that make the droplet size perfect and put that right where it needs to be.
Exactly where you need it. All right, well, this is pretty cool. I'm looking forward to another pass.
Well, I think he's heading back to get another load.
Contrary to what I thought, aerial spraying or crop dusting like this lets the farmer apply precise amounts of fungicide or insecticide directly to the corn plants. This is just one more thing Justin and his family do to ensure they get a healthy corn crop out of every field.